electrochemistry and chemical kinetics. In this topic, we discuss a new topic, that is battery. So, battery or batteries. The arrangement of one or more galvanized cells in a series is called as battery, or the arrangement of one or more galvanized cells, the chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, is also called as battery. Okay, two definitions. One is the connecting of one or more galvanized cells in a series are called as battery, or the arrangement of galvanized cells which conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy is called as battery. These batteries are classified into two types. One is primary battery and second one is secondary battery. So in that first one, primary battery. First one is primary battery. Primary battery means after the use of a period, this cell or the battery undergoes death and there is no use of re again. Okay, there is no use after discharging of that battery is called as primary battery. Means the primary battery is used for only some period of time. After completion of that time, this is not used. So this primary battery, best example is dry cell. This dry cell is discovered by Leclanché. That's why after the discovery of dry cell, this dry cell is called as Leclanché cell. Okay, the dry cell is the best example for primary battery. So generally primary batteries are used in preparation of transistors or clocks. In dry cell, generally in any battery you are considered one is anode electrode and one is cathode electrode. In primary battery of dry cell, anode is zinc rod. In cathode electrode is magnesium oxide and carbon powder is act as a cathode. And these two electrodes, the space between the electrodes are filled by one electrolytic solution, that is ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. This is act as electrolytic solution. Means in dry cell, anode is zinc rod, cathode is magnesium oxide and carbon powder. The space between the anode and cathode is filled by one electrolytic solution, that is ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. In primary battery, the representation of primary battery for dry cell, the chemical reaction is a complex reaction. The representation is very difficult, but in simple way it is represented like at anode. So here zinc is act as an anode. So that is at anode means oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electrons. Zn plus 2 electrons. At cathode, here magnesium oxide, or sometimes it is act as a manganese oxide. Okay, the manganese oxide plus electrons plus ammonium NH4+, because we use ammonium chloride, it is converted to manganese oxide with NH3. Means during this process the manganese metal is undergoes reduced from plus 4 oxidation state to plus 3 oxidation state. So means the plus 4 oxidation state is converted to plus 3. This is a reduction process. So that reduction process occurs at cathode, at anode oxidation process. The overall cell reaction is takes place in dry cell is this one. And another example for primary battery is mercuric cell. Pick mercuric cell. In this mercuric cell, here also we consider two types. One is anode electrode and one is cathode electrode. In mercuric cell, anode is, here anode is mercuric oxide. Means that is nothing but your again zinc metal. Here cathode is mercuric oxide. And here also the space between anode and cathode is filled by an electrolytic solution. That electrolytic solution is potassium hydroxide and lead hydroxide. So these two are act as a electrolytic solution. Anode is zinc rod, mercuric oxide is cathode. In mercuric cell, the overall cell reaction, is, here also zinc is act as a oxidation reagent. Zinc plus mercuric oxide is converted to zinc oxide plus mercury. This is a overall cell reaction, is overall cell reaction in mercuric cell. So after the use of a particular time, these cells or batteries are undergoes death. Okay. So the primary battery example is, one is dry cell and one is mercuric cell. And second one is secondary battery. The secondary battery means after the use of a period of time, these batteries are again discharged and recharged. So such type of batteries are called as secondary battery. Means primary batteries are not used after death, but secondary batteries are reused by discharging process or charging process. So such batteries are called as secondary battery. This secondary battery example is lead storage battery. The best example is lead storage battery. So this is an example for secondary battery. In lead storage battery, so again battery is containing two electrodes, one is anode electrode and one is cathode electrode. Here anode, in lead storage battery, the anode is, here act as lead oxide. Anode is lead oxide, here cathode is lead. And here also we use one electrolytic solution. That electrolytic solution is concentrated sulfuric acid, that is your 38% concentrated sulfuric acid we use. Means in lead storage battery, anode is lead oxide, cathode is lead. Electrolytic solution is 38% of concentrated sulfuric acid. In lead storage battery, the overall cell reaction is lead plus lead oxide, and use your concentrated sulfuric acid H2SO4 is converted to lead sulfate. 2 moles of lead sulfate and produce 2 moles of water. This is the overall cell reaction which is involved in lead storage battery. This lead storage battery is an example of secondary battery. And another example for secondary battery is nickel cadmium cell. So this is the second example for secondary battery. In this nickel cadmium cell, the overall cell reaction is nickel hydroxide is react with cadmium, which is converted to cadmium hydroxide and produce nickel hydroxide. So this is the overall cell reaction which is occurred in nickel cadmium cell. But the nickel cadmium cell is a most powerful battery than lead storage battery. And nickel cadmium cell having high expensive character, it costs more. The nickel cadmium cell and lead storage battery. These two are the examples of secondary battery. Means only one difference. The primary battery, after the use of a period of time, we cannot use. But secondary batteries are used after a period of time, because in this we are involving discharging and charging process. Okay, so these are the examples for primary battery and secondary battery. Now we discuss in another physical chemistry branch, that is chemical kinetics.